So recently, I was working on my latest kitbashing model. I 3D printed it, so I don't even know if you can call it kitbashing. It was more like 3D print bashing, I guess. But anyway, I was using my Dremel tool to cut into resin. And if you want to see the video on how this thing turned out, that'll be next week's video. But anyway, as I was cutting it, the resin powder was just going everywhere. And I thought, this can't be safe. Now, I was wearing a mask and things like that just to kind of take care of myself. But as I was thinking about that and the safeties of 3D printing, I thought about other videos that I posted on 3D printing. And I get a lot of comments from people freaking out about how dangerous 3D printing it is and everything else. And I keep saying, maybe I should do a video on that. Maybe I should do a video on that. And today I did. So let's talk about it. Is 3D printing as dangerous as you think it is? Hopefully, today we'll figure that out. So, one of the confusing things that even I noticed when I was looking this up is that if you type in the dangers of 3D printing, you don't generally get both kinds of printers that are used in our hobby. You usually get FDM or resin. So let's start with FDM printers. FDM printers print from a spool. Now, the material that they print can be varied. There's a lot of different ones. The main ones that you're going to see is going to be PLA and ABS. And there's other things in between, but these are kind of the two sides of the safe versus dangerous filaments that you print with. So let's talk about those. So the way that these printers work is that they take this plastic. You can handle the plastic with your hands. It's not a big deal. You don't have to wear gloves or anything like that. I mean, of the two printers, this one is definitely the safest. And that's why I feel like you have them in classrooms and schools and libraries and things like that. Because overall, really safe printers. But they have to heat up this plastic, this PLA, this ABS, whatever material it is. They have to heat it up and get it to the point where it starts to make fumes. Okay, and at that point, you get what's called a VOC or volatile organic compound. And basically, these are like plastics and other things that get released into the air whenever you are melting something down or printing something. It's basically the tiny little molecule-sized plastic chunks that go into the air when you do anything. Okay, and so, I mean, is 3D printing the only stuff that put this out there? No, there's tons of stuff that put this out there. But when you're printing, it puts a lot of it out there. Most of you have gone camping and put a plastic bottle or something like that in the fire and had your parents freak out because of how bad it is for the environment. Same difference, but instead of it being a fire pit, it's a small little tiny fire in a room in your home, potentially. So, is it dangerous? First, I want to start out by saying that PLA versus ABS. There's a huge difference. ABS is like a really strong material, but it has to be super hot in order to print it. And so it puts out 33 to 38 more VOC, okay, or plastic into the air. So take everything I'm saying as we're talking about PLA, and then just times that by 33, and you'll have how bad ABS is. The University of Florida has this 3D printer policy that they've released, and it's kind of like, it's basically the rules that determine how many printers should be in a room and it is safe for people. And according to them, you can have one per office or two per classroom. And this is with people inside those rooms and printing. Okay. And so, yeah, I mean, if you have a bedroom in your home that you want to put a printer in, you can put a printer in it and you can print on it. Again, talking about PLA, ABS, 33 times worse, should not be in your room with you. You should put it somewhere else. It should be in a highly ventilated area. The 3D printing safety fact sheet from Carnegie Mellon University, I have to read this because there's so much stuff, recommends that air volumes in a room with an active printer should be replaced 4 times per hour. So, how do you determine that? Well, I have this fancy little chart, okay? And it will tell you how to find out exactly how often the air volume in your room is getting replaced. It's ridiculous, but just take a look at it. If you're that curious, pause it, write it down, figure it out. Most bedrooms in your home with standard ventilation receive 5 to 6 changes of air per hour. So, in order to be safe following those paperwork, I mean, bedrooms in your home are safe because they're getting it 5 to 6 times, whereas the recommended is 3 to 4. So you're replacing the air in the room often enough that it's not a safety precaution. So feel free, go ahead and print. Now, with that being said, and I got to say this with everything, there are people that are more susceptible to getting, you know, allergic reactions or, you know, asthma, things like that. And you just got to take that into precaution. But for the most part, printing with PLA in your home is not that dangerous. If you're worried about it, put in a room where nobody is, open a window, print. And then when it's done, you just shut everything off and you should be good. Okay, so the one most people want to know about is resin printers. And the reason for that, and I'm not going into a ton of detail on like quality and things like that on printers, but resins produce the highest quality. So if you're doing miniatures and things like that, you're going to want a resin printer. Can you do it with FDM? Yes, of course you can. I have other videos on that. Okay, resin is just the highest quality. It's always going to be. So is it dangerous? Yes. It is. Resin is toxic, or according to some labels, it's slightly toxic, which I don't understand. You know, either you're toxic or you're not, you know. So let's just assume for all resins out there that they are toxic. So you can't drink them. They gotta be out of reach of kids. Okay. And that includes your printer, because your printer has a big pool of resin just sitting in it. And if a kid can reach that, well, they can reach resin. So make sure that your printers, wherever they are out of reach of kids. That could, should kind of just be a no-brainer. Sorry. Keep it away from kids if you want to be safe. It's just like dish soap and Tide Pods. Like, just keep them away from kids, right? Because we know what happens. It shouldn't, but it does. Okay? So, resin. Yes, toxic. Can you touch it? People are going to tell you different things. The truth is that it's not good for your skin. Try to avoid getting it on your hands and your skin. If it happens, it's not the end of the world. It says right on the bottles just to wash it with soap and water. And this is multiple bottles. They're not going to tell you that you'll die. They do tell you that you should handle it with gloves. And you should. I mean, I'll come right out and say it. You should handle this stuff with gloves for multiple reasons. But do it. Okay? Handle it with gloves. With that being said, people have allergic reactions to resin sometimes. Okay? Whether it's on your skin, maybe right now you don't, but apparently you can develop it. So try to keep it off of you as much as you can. Just, you know, do your best. Use your best judgment, okay? And try to not get it on you at all. But if it happens, it happens. Clean it off. You should be fine. Just like FDM, resin has a VOC as well. So it emits stuff into the air. Okay? And that changes, depending on multiple factors, the kind of printer you have, how warm your printer is, and things like that. But again, we're just going to be talking about standards. And for those of you wondering, if your printer is heated up, the hotter the printer is, the more that it puts out. So just kind of side note on that. So the levels of VOC that gets emitted from these printers is 3 to 6 times higher than an FDM printer. Now, is that for ABS? Is that for PLA? Don't know. I'm assuming they're just kind of going off of averages and stuff like that. I would assume PLA is kind of their test subject just because it is the number one printing material. So you're looking at it's 3 to 6 times worse than FDM for the stuff that it puts into the air. So what does that mean? Well, if you have a really well ventilated area, it's not that big of a deal. It doesn't mean much. Okay. These printers, I mean, it's resin. It's got a toxic chemical in it. It shouldn't be right near people anyway. But if you have a room in your house that you don't use and you can close and lock the door and print stuff, most prints take a couple hours. So if you print and then go to bed, wake up the next morning, you should be fine. Okay, it's not something that you have to just be scared about all the time. It's something that, to be cautious, spend as little time around it as you can. I mean, it should be something you go to, you get what you need out of it, you leave. You shouldn't be sitting there just, you know, huffing fumes from resin, because that'll kill you. Okay, and one thing to point out with resin is that it's constantly putting out those fumes. Constantly. Whether or not it's just sitting in the vat or printing. Obviously, when it prints, it goes way up. It increases a ton. And then, you wouldn't think it, but when you clean it, it goes off a ton too, because now you're mixing with isopropyl alcohol, which has its own fumes. And so if you can clean it with something other than isopropyl alcohol, it's always going to be safer. It'll be better. And if you can get the water washable resin, it's way better as far as fumes in the air, just because you wash it with water and it doesn't put them into the air. So does that mean if you get a printer, it has to go out in your garage? No, you can put a printer in most places in your home. You just got to be careful with who's in there while it's printing. You got to make sure the room is ventilated, which, like I said, most rooms are relatively well ventilated. You know, if you print something, give it a couple hours before you go get it and you should be fine. It's not that scary. I mean, it's a hobby that millions of people are a part of, and they're not talking about how it killed them or anything like that yet. But I mean, err on the side of caution. Why wouldn't you? So printing isn't something to be afraid of. It's not going to kill you. I mean, unless you are like drinking bottles of resin. Okay, it's not going to kill you. You'll be fine. Okay, and no two setups are alike. So just be cautious and you'll be fine. Everything will go out great. You'll get the prints. You'll get everything you want. And you'll have no health side effects to talk about. You don't need a separate house. You don't need a huge setup, a ventilation setup and things like that. Are they helpful? Yeah, of course. The more ventilated a room is, the better it's going to be for everyone in it. Okay. And when it comes to filters and resin, it's got to be one of those charcoal filters, because apparently they're the only ones that work. So just kind of keep that in mind. Do everything you can to make this hobby as safe as you can. So I'm curious, what does your setup look like? What have you done to make this safe for you? Or are you not making it safe for you? And if so, why? You know, the information that I found is the most concrete stuff that I could find. Is it absolute? No, there's still a ton they don't know about printing with resin. But for the most part, I think these are really good guidelines for anyone looking to get into the hobby. So let me know down below if you think I'm crazy or if you think I'm right on. And if you think I'm right, please like, subscribe, follow the channel. Like I said, I'll show you how that model turned out in next week's video. And I think it was really cool. And I'm looking forward to doing more 3D print bashing in the future. So stick around for that. Here at Pulsegate Games, we're all about making your experience tabletop gaming the best it can be and the safest. So stick around. And as always, don't spend so much time making your world, printing your world, that you forget to spend some time in it. Until next time.